Ta vikend ne vozim, ta vikend je moj praznik. Na to mi je povedal angleški tovornjakar, ki je sicer sem v Le Mans prišel navijati za svojega rojaka Marka Taylorja, ampak je takoj dodal, da ne, Le Mans ni samo tovornjaška dirka, Le Mans je tovornjaška zabava leta. Fešta vseh fešt. Ampak da boste dobili občutek, kako zelo velik praznik je to, poglejmo nekaj sekundno montažo. Samo Le Mans nisem prispel samo zato, da bi videl, kako se dirkači podijo po tej Bugatti stezi, ampak tudi zaradi ene gumarske zgodbe. Namreč zaradi fascinantnega podatka, da gume iz teh tovornjakov, te dirkaške gume, na koncu nadaljujejo svojo pot po cesti, na serijskih tovornjakih. Na to misel morate slišati.
The structure that we have on the racing tires is a structure which is in fact the same as the one used on our traditional tires. So that structure is made and developed in order to be capable to make 200-250,000 kilometers and be retreaded. For the race tires, we put that extra layer of special compound with very shallow non-skid because it's to be used on a sprint race. But after race, we take them back, we put them through a series of quality checks, and from there, tires run at Le Mans will be tomorrow on a trailer somewhere in Europe. In our new tires, we've replaced the traditional element which is used as reinforcing, which is carbon black, with silica. This is something which we have been using for years. It was usually used on the tread material for the truck tires. Now the magic is we put this inside, in the carcass of the tire. Those metallic elements which are in the tire are surrounded by a compound which has a content of silica. And what's great about that is, first of all, it helps us have a tire which has a still very good mileage, because we don't put all the burden of delivering low energy consumption on the tread, but also on the carcass. And we use a specific silica material. This silica usually is made out of sand. Now what we do is we take what we call rice husk ash silica, so from rice that you can eat. You still keep that part for eating, to feed people or animals. And then you have the husk. This husk is being dried, then burned to create energy, for example, to produce electricity. Then out of this burning, you have ashes, and those ashes are treated chemically. So if you take those ashes and you treat them, you get a silica material that is renewable because it's part of that circle, and that you can put into tires. And thanks to that, we can do with our EQ Max up to 55% content of sustainable material. The next challenge will be to make also the carbon black renewable. And there are ways. There are already ways that we are looking into. They are not yet in production, but there are already ways where you can make that out of methane, out of recycling directly tires. You can, you know, you can take a tire which has been worn, you can make also the air treatment, out of that you get some oil, and from that oil can be used either into making some fuels, but also can be burned to make carbon black, which is then reinjected into the production. We are pushing, and Goodyear has the commitment to bring in 2030 a tire which is made of full sustainable material. There is lots of work. There are already passenger tires which are beyond 80%, which are on sales in the US. We've developed tires which are beyond 90%, and it's doing tires which are containing a very high amount of sustainable material. We can do it. The big challenge in sustainable material is not necessarily to go after the biggest amount of sustainable material. The problem is how to get enough of the material to go into mass production, and at a reasonable price.
Zdaj, ko je malce bolj mirno, predlagam, da se pomenimo o tehniki. Zdaj, ta vikend se s to stezo ukvarjajo 5300 kg težki tovornjaki in s to visoko maso se spopada 1200 koničev. Največji navor je 5500 Nm, pride pa iz 13000 kubičnih centimetrov velikih motorjev. In zdaj, naslednji podatek se vam bo mogoče v avtomobilskem smislu zdel zelo nizek, v tovornjaškem smislu pa je zelo visok. Namreč, ti motori se zavrtijo do 3000 vrtljajev na minuto. Pospešek do 100 km na uro je 5 sekund, ampak še bolj fascinanten podatek pa je ta, da ti tovornjaki od 30 km na uro do 160, kolikor je najvišja hitrost teh tovornjakov, pospešijo v komaj 7 sekundah. In zdaj, da si boste znali predstavljati, to je tako hitro kot to zmore tudi Porsche 911 GT3. Seveda pa je vse te težke tovornjake treba tudi ustaviti in zato imajo te tovornjaki poleg klasičnega zavornega tokokroga še en zasilen, ki mora prijeti v vsakem trenutku vsaj dve kolesi, tudi takrat, ko glavni zavorni sistem odpove. Seveda pa to ne pomeni, da do stikov med tovornjaki ne prihaja, ker nekaj sem jih posnel. No, ob naslednjem kadru pa vsem ljubiteljem dirk moje generacije sporočam, da sem se počutil kar malce nostalgično. V Le Mans so si prišli pokazati tudi proizvajalci tovornjakov in seveda prišli so potrobiti, na ves glas potrobiti, da tudi v ta tovornjaški posel prihaja električni pogon. Seveda tukaj zbrana druščina ima malce drugačno mnenje, predvsem pa je treba vedeti, da dirkaški tovornjaki na 100 km porabijo kar 100 litrov biodizla. In seveda, če pomislimo, da bi želeli takšno energijsko lakoto nahraniti s baterijami, to pomeni, da bi bili te dirkaški tovornjaki res samo še bistveno težji.
The idea behind all those that racing that we have in motorsport is really to use as much as we can of existing technologies. Like the fuel, it's a sustainable fuel, but it's a fuel that, let's say, truckers, big companies can buy outside. This is this HVO fuel, which is available and is from sustainable sources. I think that electric trucks, there would be a huge problem of having the batteries, how to recharge them and everything, and it's also quite heavy load as well. The future for racing would be more hydrogen-powered fuel cell. That's where the FIA is looking into. We're discussing with them about that. And if we look at, you made the parallel with WEC in car series, that's also where they're looking at, they're not looking electric, but they're looking at more hydrogen-powered.
Seveda je dirke vseh dirk tukaj v Le Mansu še vedno 24 ur Le Mansa, se pravi vzdržljivostna dirka, prvenstvo WEC. In na tisti dirki seveda velja, da hrup dirkalnikov nikoli ne pojenja. Tudi po noči vsi tisti dirkalniki zares pojejo, na glas pojejo. Ampak tudi tukaj na dirki tovornjakov velja, da hrup nikoli ne pojenja. Ampak v tem primeru dirkaški tovornjaki pravzaprav sploh niso najglasnejši. Zdaj, ta nedeljska porada je pravzaprav nič v primerjavi s tem, kar vam bom pokazal zdaj. Seveda lahko zdaj pikro pripomnimo, da prav zaradi te zvočne moči si pravzaprav noben politik ne upa tovornjakarjem zares zoprstaviti. Žal se moram jaz zdaj odpraviti domov, ampak za vas pa predlagam, da še malce ostanete tukaj v Le Mansu. Za vaš naslednji klik namreč tokrat priporočam dve zgodbi, ki smo jih posneli tukaj v Le Mansu. In jaz sem se pred leti sem pripeljal s avtodomom in kamperal prav ob dirkališču, no Luka pa je sem priletel na najbolj možen dirkaški način. s Cepelinom. Uživajte.